Throughout the world, a new popular movement is emerging to resist the poverty, ecological destruction, and political oppression brought by the increasing power of large corporations and the policies of the World Trade Organization, the World Bank, and the International Monetary Fund. On November 30th, 1999, this movement gained international attention when 70,000 demonstrators converged in the streets of Seattle to shut down the annual meeting of the World Trade Organization. The U.S. Constitution guarantees the right to assemble and speak out against injustice. But when demonstrators in Seattle sought to exercise this right, the police responded with pepper spray, tear gas, concussion grenades, rubber bullets, beatings, and arrests. Over 600 people were jailed and thousands suffered injuries during 3 days of police violence. In the face of the worst police violence in years, the nonviolent demonstrators succeeded in disrupting the WTO meeting and preventing the body from advancing its pro-corporate agenda. On April 16, 2000, the movement again made headlines when it descended upon Washington, D.C. to protest the International Monetary Fund and the World Bank, two bodies that have increased poverty and suffering in poor countries for over 50 years. These events demonstrate that there is a growing awareness of the interconnectedness of the world's economies and of the need to organize across borders to stand up against those who put profits ahead of people's lives.
Revolution is now for God!
After years of struggle outside the public view, the movement to end corporate globalization has taken center stage, giving voice to the demand for life with dignity spoken by the Zapatistas and millions of other poor people around the world who dare to say, enough.